Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have another stroller review video for you guys because I am obsessed with strollers and we have a new one in our lives. This is the City Mini Double Side-by-Side Stroller. So I wanted to share with you guys my thoughts on it, and I also wanted to compare it to our UppaBaby Vista because if anyone else out there is trying to decide between these two strollers or trying to decide between an inline and a double side-by-side, I wanted to share my thoughts on that with you guys. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Marian. I make videos about being a Jewish mom, and I have two little boys, an almost 3-year-old and an almost 6-month-old, and I have tested my fair share of strollers. I will link all my reviews down below so you guys can see them. So let's jump into the City Mini Double. So we were kindly given this stroller by my sister as a hand-me-down, so it is not the latest 2019 version. It's a few years old, but it is in amazing condition and we are so thankful to have it. So first I want to talk to you guys about what it's like having a double side-by-side compared to an inline. Seeing as I have both, I feel like I am a good person to share with you guys what I think. I love this stroller as a side-by-side because it is under 30 inches wide across, which means it fits through all standard doorways. There's a rule in the United States based on the American Disabilities Act that all doorways and aisleways have to be at least that wide for wheelchairs. So this stroller is perfect because if you want to take it in and out of anywhere, coffee shops, like anywhere, it'll fit through the doorway. It seems like it's not going to, it just definitely makes me a little bit nervous sometimes, but it always fits, so it's great. And not all double side-by-side strollers are like that. We had the Tool double jogging stroller side-by-side for a hot second before I returned it because I couldn't get it out my own door. So there are definitely some larger side-by-side strollers, but this one is great. Next, I want to talk to you guys about weight. This is a super lightweight double stroller. In my opinion, it is not hard to get in and out of the car. It is not hard to push around. It's really not heavy at all and maneuvers really well. For me, getting in and out of the car is a big thing because lifting the UppaBaby, especially up into our trunk, was always really hard for me. I don't struggle as much with this one. Other than that, in terms of maneuverability, I find it very easy to push around. The wheels move well. It spins like 360 very easily. I can push it over curves, etc. It's not a jogging stroller in terms of wheels, so if you have a super bumpy road or if you're not going on a paved road, you'll definitely feel those bumps. But in terms of walking on a sidewalk or around city streets, etc., it's totally fine for that. So I wanted to talk a little bit about what it's like to have a side-by-side compared to an inline. One of the things I love about it is that I can easily access both kids. They're right there in front of me. There's not one further away or closer. They're both right there and really easy to get to. And it's nice to have their stuff right next to them as well. And I think it's nice for them to be able to communicate and sort of interact with each other. The only thing I don't like is that because you're not in an inline, it does make it a little bit harder if there are some really crowded areas, like inside a restaurant. Again, technically things should be at least 30 inches apart, but sometimes they're not. Sometimes it's a tighter squeeze. And in terms of ease of use, another thing I love about this stroller is how easy it is to fold. You just take two hands and go like this. I will demonstrate it for you guys, but it's super easy to fold and it opens with just one hand, which is a really big deal. We use this as our travel stroller, and I'll explain a bit more about that in a minute, but what I love about it is when we arrive at the airport and we always gate check our stroller and they bring it to you as soon as you get off the plane. And it's really nice because I've had gate agents, flight attendants, etc. just open the stroller for me because it's so easy to do. They all just know how to do it. You just literally open it. So that's been really nice that anyone can sort of use it and figure it out. Then I want to talk a little bit about the pockets. I love the pockets at the back of the stroller. I have like mini diaper bags, so I'll put one for each kid in there. And then under the stroller, there's a ton of room. I always take my Ergo 360 in case I want to give my baby a nap. Sometimes he's not so great at stroller naps, so I tend to wear him. And then just other food, drink, etc., all the other random equipment that you need when traveling around with kids. The thing I don't like about the storage in this stroller is it's a little hard to get to that under pocket, and you can't fit as much or as bulky an item as you might want to just because the way to access it is not that easy. In terms of the top bar, this is not the GT version, so it's a little bit less expensive and the bar does not go up or down, but for me that doesn't bother me. It's at a totally fine height for me. I prefer saving on the weight versus some of those extra features, but of course this was a gift to me handed down, so I didn't have those choices anyways, but I still think I would have gone for this one if I had paid for it. So let's talk comparison. The reason I use this as my travel stroller and not my everyday stroller is for my everyday stroller we use an UppaBaby CRUZ with with a kickstand. So my son is almost 3 and he doesn't need to sit in the stroller if we're just running out on errands. And because he's in nursery school, I'm often going around with just my little baby. So I love having the CRUZ with the kickstand because I can use it as a single stroller, and then with my older sons with me to just go, you know, in and out of preschool, in and out of the grocery store, he can just stand on the kickstand. So that works out really well for us. If he was a bit closer in age to my younger son, that might not be the greatest option, but for us it works out really well. However, when we're traveling, we're going longer distances in the stroller, we're going around Disneyland, airports, all that kind of stuff, and we're also going for stroller walks around neighborhoods and things like that, so I need to have a double stroller that he can sit in. We did have the Uppababy Vista. We actually sold it. I found it way too heavy and cumbersome to use as a double, and I don't regret that decision at all. I still love this one for traveling and for when I need 2 kids sitting. We also have a double jogging stroller. We have the Phil and Ted Sport that I use as my walk around the neighborhood stroller at home, but I don't travel with that one because it's too big and bulky for the car. So yes, I have the luxury of having multiple different strollers for different uses, but I honestly think if I had to pick one all-in-one, I might pick the City Mini double. It doesn't have all the bells and whistles. It's not so super fancy deluxe as the Uppababy, but it's really nice, really useful, and pretty lightweight. So this might be my go-to all-around pick if I had to choose just one. Also, I want to let you guys in on a little secret. Everyone I know that has the Uppababy Vista has given up on it with their second kid once they're out of that infant stage because it's just too heavy to use. I dare you to look around. Anytime you actually see an Uppababy Vista, look at how many kids are actually in it and how it's being used. I, 1 in 10, maybe 1 in 20 times will actually see it being used as a double stroller. So I don't want to hate on it. I did love it for when I used it as a single stroller, but it was always a little big and cumbersome for me versus this, which I think is super useful as a double. So that's just my take on it. I love the stroller. It's super nice. And the only thing I fault it for is the access to the under storage compartment. But that's about it. So that is my review of the City Mini double side by side. I hope it's helped you guys out. I hope I've given you something to think about if you're considering which double side-by-side to get. If you have any questions for me about any of these strollers, drop them in the comments. I will make sure to reply. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!